Tortured, gutted, mangled, and left to be found by a wandering toddler, James Habersham was one of many victims who died at the hands of one of the sickest serial killers we've ever featured on the show, John Janky, or John the Gripper. Welcome to Basking in Blood. I'm your host, Polly the Pal, here with Ronnie Habersham, the victim's very own brother.
Thanks for having me, Polly.
Polly the Pal.
Polly the, pal.
So your brother was famously turned inside out. Now how does that make you, the victim's brother, feel?
It was the singular most devastating thing to ever happen to me or my family my entire life.
Oh, I bet.
I actually wanted to talk about how the media kind of spun everything out, you know, ever since that kid stumbled upon his body. I mean, all we've really needed was just some time to grieve.
Grief certainly is a bitch, which segues us into our first sponsor.
What?
That's right, Basking in Blood is brought to you by Mattress Palace. In a world crawling with grisly killers and creatures of the night, nothing will make you sleep through the screams of bloody murder like a Mattress Palace Pally mattress.
Well, getting back to what I was saying earlier, you know, I think it's just really terrible that the way that, the media, and really especially podcasts, have spun his death into trying to make it such a spectacle.
Well, it could almost make you crazy.
It really does, Polly, it really does.
What do you think, Ronnie, brings a man to commit a random act of violence so gnarly, so disgusting, such as turning your brother into a splattered bowl of spaghetti?
Look, man, I'm just trying to level with you here, but you're exactly what I'm talking about. I mean, you bring me onto your podcast to talk about my brother's death, and then all you want to talk about is the guy, that my brother's killer, that ruined my life? I mean, I just think it's really ridiculous. I mean, I dropped out of school. My mother was bedridden for months. I mean, that boy who found him, Dennis O'Reilly, he hasn't recovered. He's been in and out of mental institutions. I mean, there's just so much shit that's come from this. It's horrible. And you want me to come on here and talk about all that shit? Just for your viewers' little kicks? Just for a few laughs?
Oh, Mike. My goodness, Ronnie. I'm sorry, man. We have a certain thing that we do on this show. I guess I got a little carried away. I'm sorry. I'm just here to, you know, I wanted to give you a platform.
Thank you. Thank you, man. I really appreciate that. A lot.
But first, a quick word from our sponsor. With the code PAL, you can get 25% off of Who Da Killa. Who Da Killa lets you become a real-life true crime detective. And this month's theme is, you guessed it, John the Gripper. Can you piece together the evidence to jail John Janky? Peel over primary documents, witness interviews, and crime scene photos like this.
Oh, God, you're a sick bastard, you know that? You want to hear about murder? You want to hear about all the grimy, the grisly details? Well, you're well on your way to experiencing some murder firsthand, little guy. God, you sick fuck!
Well, it seems like I must have hit a nerve, which means that, I guess the interview is effectively over. I'm sorry, Bloodbaskers, but sometimes you just get a guess that it's a real stinker. I mean, I know what happened to my buddy Ronnie was terrible, but, you know, he didn't have to have such a sour attitude about it, at least in my opinion. It just makes you wanna... Oh, well, I'm not gonna let some stinker of a guest dampen my mood. And you know why? Because Willie's wipes can sop up anything. And I mean anything. I'm talking corn syrup. I'm talking molasses. Are you picking up what I'm putting down? Willie's wipes can cover up any trail that you could possibly leave. Any single mess. So if you find yourself in a goofy situation, just grab your Willie.